Filmed by Curtis Hanson, starring Paul Giamatti, and just an extraordinary cast of it. In fact, some HBO regulars, Paul, as you know, played John Adams. HBO brought us the war in the Pacific and the war in the Atlantic, the Band of Brothers, now brings us the war at the Fed. It is fitting that we will follow the film with a conversation between two people who go beyond what we're going to see in the movie, which is obviously a digest of an extraordinary number of events which took place in a frighteningly short period of time, profoundly altered, I think, our views of what's possible in government, altered them in ways in government and private industry, and altered them in ways that I think are what drives the underlying concern that I think we've all felt over the last few weeks as to how possible it is that the events of the last few days could have gone quite bad, and indeed may still. And with that said, first of all, on behalf of the common good, one of our two hosts this evening, the other being the Australian Cultural Center, where we are this evening, a just glorious building that I have to say. The Austrian Cultural Center, a gorgeous building, which I have to say I've walked past 10 times and never noticed what a stunning piece of architecture it is, designed by a fellow called Raymond Abraham, I believe.
Well, should I say maybe something about this thing?
Please, and talk about the building in the center.
Thank you so much. Let me first switch this on and move the mic in a moment. Can we make this louder?
Yes. Hello? Okay, now it works. So, Stephen, thank you so much. Well, we are here actually at the Austrian Cultural Forum. Don't mix up, please, Sydney and Vienna. Vienna is not only the city of Mozart, but it's also, I think, a place of cultural and intellectual creativity. We will present you with a very short film before you will actually see the main attraction of this film tonight, to fail. But I really wanted to say that we are actually quite honored and happy to host this film tonight, because what we are facing, both in Europe and in the United States, is somehow a phase of brinkmanship where politics actually is forgetting about the common good. Common good that we